the light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Dear brothers and sisters, watching at a distance, and dear brothers here present, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the Word of God. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved his people, and in these, the last days, has sent us his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption.
Exalt with him, exalt the hosts of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound aloud.
Of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb. Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. Then God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus evening came, and morning followed, the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters, to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above and the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came, and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin, so that the dry land may appear." And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin, and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of water he called the sea. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on the earth that bears fruit with its seeds in it." And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on the earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the third day. Then God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night." Let them mark the fixed times, the days and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth. And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day, and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came and morning followed, the fourth day. Then God said, let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on earth let the birds fly beneath the dome of the sky. And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the water teems, and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, be fertile, multiply, and fill the water of the seas, and let the birds multiply on earth. Evening came, and morning followed, the fifth day. Then God said, let the earth bring forth all kinds of living creatures, cattle, creeping things, and wild animals of all kinds. And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, and all kinds of creeping things of the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, let us make a man in our own image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all wild animals, and all the creatures that crawl on the ground. God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him, male and female. He created them. God blessed them, saying, be fertile, fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all living things that move on earth. God also said, see, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food. And to all the animals of the land, and all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground, I give all the green plants for food. And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made and found it very good. Evening came, and morning followed, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed, since on the seventh day God was finished with the work he had been doing. He rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Not to be moved forever, with the ocean as with a garment you covered it. Above the mountains, the waters stood. That when among the mountains, beside them the birds of heaven dwell, from among the branches they send forth their song.
Lord, send out your Spirit, and renew the face of the earth.
You water the mountains from your palace. The earth is replete with fruit of your works. You raise grass for the cattle and vegetation for man's use, producing bread from the earth.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
How manifold are your works, O Lord! In wisdom you have wrought them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who are wonderful in the ordering of all your works, may those you have redeemed understand that there exists nothing more marvelous than the world's creation in the beginning, except that, at the end of the ages, Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust. On a height that I will point out to you." Early the next morning, Abraham saddled his donkey, took with him his son Isaac, and two servants of his as well, and with the wood that he had cut for the holocaust, set out for a place of which God had told him. On the third day, Abraham got sight of the place from afar. Then he said to his servants, "Both of you stay here with the donkey, while the boy and I go on over yonder. We will worship and then come back to you." Thereupon, Abraham took the wood for the holocaust and laid it on his son Isaac's shoulders, while he himself carried the fire and a knife. As the two walked on together, Isaac spoke to his father, Abraham.
"Father,"
Isaac said.
"Yes, son," he replied.
Isaac continued, "Where are the fire and the wood? But where is the sheep for the holocaust?"
"Son," Abraham answered, "God himself will provide sheep for the holocaust." And the two continued going forward. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Next he tied up his son Isaac and put him on top of the wood on the altar. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," said the messenger. "Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your beloved son." As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So up he went and took the ram and offered it up as a holocaust in the place of his son. Abraham named the site Yahweh Yireh. Hence, people now say, "On the mountain the Lord will see." Again, the Lord's messengers called to Abraham from heaven and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did, and not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemy, and in your descendants all nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my command." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Therefore, my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body, too, abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the nether world, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption. You will show me the path to life, fullness of joy in your presence, the delights at your right hand forever.
Make your servant Abraham father of nations, as once you swore. Grant, we pray, that your peoples may enter worthily into the grace to which you call them. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. Lord said to Moses, why are you crying out to me? Tell Israel to go forward. And you lift up your staff and your hand outstretched over the sea, with the sea in two. The Israelites may pass through it on dry land. I'll make the Egyptians so obstinate, they'll go in after them. And receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and his charioteers. Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord. Receive glory through Pharaoh, his chariots and charioteers. Angel of God had been leading Israel's camp, now moved and went round behind them. The column cloud also leaving the front, took up its place behind them, came between the camp Egyptians and that of Israel. The cloud now became dark. Thus the night passed without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, so it turned into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, waters like a wall to their right and to their left. Egyptians followed in pursuit, while Pharaoh's horses and chariots and charioteers went in after them, right into the midst of the sea. Night watched before dawn, the Lord cast a column of fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force, glanced and threw it into a panic, so clogged their chariot wheels so they could hardly drive. That the Egyptians sounded their retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. The Lord said to Moses, stretch out your hand over the sea, the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon the chariots and their charioteers. Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. At dawn, the sea flowed back to its normal depth. Egyptians were laying head on toward the sea. The Lord hurled them into its midst. Waters flowed back, covered the chariots and the charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Egyptian and Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them had escaped. The Israelites had marched on dry land in the midst of the sea, water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore, beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians. They feared the Lord and believed in him, his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. I'll sing to the Lord, for his horse triumphant, horse and chariot is cast into the sea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My strength and my courage is the Lord. He has been my Savior. He is my God. I praise him. The God of my Father, I extol him.
Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory.
The Lord is a warrior. The Lord is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and his army hurled into the sea. The elite of his officers submerged into the Red Sea. The flood waters covered them. They sank in the depths like a stone. The right hand, O Lord, magnificent in power. The right hand, O Lord, has shattered the enemy. Inheritance, the place we made your seat, O Lord, the sanctuary, O Lord, your hands established. Lord shall reign forever and ever.
Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory.
pray. O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in splendor even in our day, for what you once bestowed on a single people, freeing them from Pharaoh's persecution by the power of your right hand, now you bring about as the salvation of the nations through the waters of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Book of the prophet Isaiah. The one who has become your husband is your maker. His name is Lord of hosts. Your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel. God called God from the earth. The Lord calls you back like a wife forsaken, grieved in spirit, a wife married in youth and then cast off, says to your God, for a brief moment I abandoned you, but with great tenderness I will take you back. In an outburst of wrath, for a moment I hid my face from you, but with enduring love I take pity on you, says the Lord your Redeemer. This is for me like the days of Noah, when I swore that the waters of Noah should never again deluge the earth. So I have sworn not to be angry with you or to rebuke you. Though the mountains leave their place and the hills be shaken, my love shall never leave you, nor my covenant of peace be shaken, says the Lord, who has mercy on you. O afflicted one, storm-battered and unconsoled, I lay your pavements in its canopies, and your foundation in sapphires. I will make your battlements of rubies, your gates of carbuncles, and all your walls of precious stones. All your children shall be taught by the Lord, and the great shall be in the peace of your children. In justice shall you be established, for from fear of oppression, where destruction cannot come near you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to the Lord, you his faithful ones, and give thanks to his holy name. For his anger lasts but a moment, a lifetime his goodwill. At nightfall, weeping enters in, but with the dawn, rejoicing. Change my mourning into dancing. O Lord my God, forever will I give you thanks.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever living God, surpass for the honor of your name what you pledged to the patriarchs by reason of their faith, and through sacred adoption increase the children of your promise, so that what the saints of old never doubted would come to pass, your church may now see in great part fulfilled through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come, without paying and without cost, drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me. You shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me, heedful. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David. As I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and a commander of nations, so shall you summon a nation you knew not, and nations that knew you not shall run you, because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, who has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his ways, and the wicked man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God who is generous and forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. For just as from the heavens the rain and the snow came down, and do not return there, till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Savior, I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. With joy you will draw water at the fountain of salvation.
You will draw water, and your life will be.
Give thanks to the Lord, acclaim his name. Among the nations, make known his deeds. Proclaim how exalted is his name. Sing praise to the Lord for his glorious achievements. Let this also be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
Unveiled the mysteries of this present age, graciously increased the longing of your people. For only the prompting of your grace do the faithful progress in any kind of virtue. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Prophet Baruch. Hear, O Israel, commandment of life. Listen and know prudence. How is it, Israel, that you are in the land of your foes, grown old in a foreign land, defiled with the dead, counted with those destined to another world? Forsaken the fountain of wisdom, you walk the way of God, who dwelt in enduring peace. Learn where prudence is, where strength, where understanding, made know also where the length of days and life, where the light of the eyes and peace, that found the place of wisdom, was entered into her treasuries. The one who knows all things knows her. He has probed her by his knowledge. The one who established the earth for all time, filled it with four-footed beasts, dismissed the light and departs, calls it and obeys him trembling. Before whom the stars repose, shine and rejoice. He calls them, they answer, here we are, shine with joy with our Maker. Such is our God. No other is to be compared to him. He has traced out the whole way of understanding, given her to Jacob, his servant, to Israel, his beloved son. Since then, she's appeared on earth, moved among people. She's the book of the precepts of God, the law that endures forever. All cling to her will live. Those who will die will forsake her. Turn, O Jacob, receive her. Walk by her light toward splendor. Give not your glory to another, your privileges to an alien race. Blessed are we, O Israel. What pleases God is known to us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Refreshing the soul. Creed of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple.
Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye.
Lord, you have the
fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just. More precious than gold, than a heap of purest gold, sweeter also than syrup, or honey from the comb.
Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
Let us pray. O God, who constantly increase your church by your call to the nations, graciously grant to those you wash clean in the waters of baptism the assurance of your unfailing protection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, when the house of Israel lived in their land, they defiled it by their conduct and deeds. Therefore I pour out my fury upon them, because of the blood that they poured out on the ground, and because they defiled it with idols. I scattered them among the nations, dispersing them over foreign lands. According to their conduct and deeds I judged them. But when they came among the nations, wherever they came, they served to profane my holy name, because it was said of them, These are the people of the Lord, yet they had to leave their land. So I have relented because of my holy name, which the house of Israel profaned among the nations where they came. Therefore say to the house of Israel, Thus says the Lord God, Not for your sakes do I act, house of Israel, but for the sake of my holy name, which you profane among the nations to which you came. I will prove the holiness of my great name profaned among the nations, in whose midst you have profaned it. Thus the nation shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord God, when in their sight I prove my holiness through you. For I will take you away from among the nations, gather you from all the foreign lands, and bring you back to your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you to cleanse you from all your impurities, and from all your idols I will cleanse you. I will give you a new heart and place a new spirit within you, taking from your bodies your stony hearts and giving you natural hearts. I will put my spirit within you and make you live by my statutes, careful to observe my decrees. You shall live in the land I gave your fathers. You shall be my people, and I will be your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thirst is my soul for God, the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall return to you.
Lord,
pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a holocaust, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn. Let us pray. O God, of unchanging power and eternal light, look with favor on the wondrous mystery of the whole Church, and serenely accomplish the work of human salvation, which you plan from all eternity. May the whole world know and see that what was cast down is raised up, what had become old is made new, and all things are restored to integrity through Christ, just as by him they came into being, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who make this most sacred night radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your Church a spirit of adoption, so that, renewed in body and mind, we may render you undivided service through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we had grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For if a dead person has been absolved from sin, if then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ raised from the dead dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, approached, rolled back the stone, and sat upon it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards were shaken with fear of him and became like dead men. Then the angel said to the women in reply, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus the crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead, and he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." Then they went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce this to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
First of all, I'd like to ask God's blessing to come upon each and every one of you, that you might have a happy, holy, and healthy Easter and throughout the Easter season. We are blessed with many passages of Scripture, and so it would be difficult to preach just on one of them. So we have to look at the overall message of what we're hearing and what we experienced in this liturgy on the Easter Vigil. God, as we are told in the first reading, created light, and then all goodness comes in the rest of God's creation. Sin, then, inspired by Satan, brought darkness. Christ Jesus recreates or restores the goodness darkened by sin. He brings light and goodness back to all creation. This evening, this vigil, we celebrate Christ Jesus' action. We have the new fire as Christ recreated the earth. We have the Easter candle symbolizing the risen Lord, which, as it burns, it consumes itself, putting forth a warm but bright light. God's word, his plan, is set forth in all of those passages of the sacred scripture that we've heard this evening. From creation to the resurrection, and the mystery was there. We have been bowed down far too long to darkness, a view of life without God in the picture. That's what God's people experienced about 3,000 years ago. The world didn't come to an end then. The world is not going to come to an end now because of the fact that we have been looking through lenses of darkness. Tonight we visualize what Christ has done. And by our participation, whether it is at a distance, as you see this on your computer, or whether it is the clergy here who witness it in firsthand experience, we can look past the moments in our lives when we have doubted God's power to transform us. There's no need to fear. That's what the scripture says also. The women came to the tomb. They didn't find it the way they expected. We didn't find this Easter the way we expected it to be either. And of course, we could be fearful and wonder and waste our time deliberating on how long we're going to endure this situation that we're in. Those things make no difference. What makes a difference is, where is our focus in life? Is it on God and his Son, the Savior of the world, Jesus Christ? Or is it on all the distractions? And this would just be one big one to be distracted with. Or is it all the little distractions that we will use so that we don't think about the big one? That's what we have to ask ourselves. We don't need to doubt, as I mentioned, the power of God to transform us. There is no need to be afraid. In fact, Jesus says, "Do not fear." And I could add, on this Easter Vigil night, with the Christ candle before me,
Christ will bring you light.
Blessing of the water of baptism. We have no baptisms this evening, but we will no doubt have baptisms in the coming months. And so I will bless the water, and we will have a chance to renew our baptismal promises. God, who by invisible power accomplished a wondrous effect through sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit, in the first moments of the world's creation, hovered over the waters, so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, so that from the mystery of one and the same element of water would come an end to vice and a beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people set free from slavery to Pharaoh would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side, along with blood, and after his resurrection, commanded his disciples, "Go forth, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the font of baptism. May this water receive by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism from all the squalor of the life of old may be found worthy to rise to the life of newborn children through water and the Spirit. We pray the power of the Holy Spirit, Lord, to come down through your Son into the fullness of this water, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. We'll renew our baptismal promises, and then I'll sprinkle you with holy water. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promise to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works,
I do.
And all his empty show,
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. now will offer our petitions, and filled with the joy of Christ's resurrection, as we are this evening, we now turn to our loving God with our needs and the needs of the world.
For Pope Francis, all bishops, clergy, and leaders of the Church, may God's wisdom and compassion and mercy guide them as they share the good news of salvation with all people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all civic authorities, may their decisions and actions be motivated by God's plan for peace and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who feel lost, abandoned, excluded, or rejected, may God's love and mercy present in His Church lead them home to Him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those welcomed and initiated into the body of Christ, may God's overwhelming love affirm their gifts and inspire them to share the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died in Christ, may they know the fullness of joy in sharing in the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to this pandemic of a coronavirus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those intentions we hold in our own hearts and are known to us and God alone, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Glorious God, you raised your Son to new life, winning for us our salvation. Renew in us our wonder and joy in all that you've done for us. Hear the prayers we make this night and always, and grant them in the name of your risen Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, we will be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, Lord, from my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church. Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us the healing of eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this night, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as without end they acclaim. Sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Lawrence, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Benedict and Saint Scholastica, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. By divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other an appropriate sign of peace. Peace, bonds. Peace, bonds. Peace, deacons. Peace to all of you. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it.
Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this paschal sacrament one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen. Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen. Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia.